Happy Thursday, everybody. Well, we had some breaks in the clouds this morning for some of our sky cams. Our South Jackson sky cam looking a bit more gloomy with low-lying clouds crossing right along the tree lining. Eventually, that will erode and we will see the sunshine today before the rain and storms overtake the picture. Highs this afternoon, mid to low 80s. The Jackson Metro expected to be right around 83 degrees. We're watching two systems this afternoon that will affect multiple states today. Round one from Arkansas and Louisiana. That's what's going to affect us this afternoon. Then we have another round back off towards Kansas, Nebraska, and Arkansas, which will bring another chance for strong to severe thunderstorms in their region. So let's talk a little bit more about what we can expect today. We're going to be dry this morning, but we have a yellow icon in the place because of a flash flood threat west of I-55. This system is going to bring torrential downpours to where we could see several inches of rain accumulating in a very short amount of time. Anywhere from Vicksburg all the way down to Adams County will have the threat for seeing 2 to 4 inches today. There's already a flood watch in effect for this because of the torrential downpours. Now, we're not just looking at heavy rain and a lightning with this as well. We're looking also at the possibility of sub-severe gusts, 30 to 50 miles an hour possible within this front edge of the line itself, as well as hail associated with this. I don't think we're going to see a lot of hail threats with this system today, but it is on the isolated side. The heaviest the rain clears out by around 5-6 o'clock this evening, and we'll continue to watch these lingering showers progress up until around midnight, and it will be damp but dry overnight. So rainfall totals region wide expected to range around 1 to 3 inches. And then again, our river county is a little bit higher, 2 to 4 inches in isolated locations. So tonight, once the rain clears out, we stay overcast. Wake up temperatures back into the 60s. Highs tomorrow afternoon warm up a little bit more. Mid to upper 80s with real field values in red. Mid to low 90s. I think we're going to stay more on the drier side tomorrow. But with that daytime heating, we could have a couple of late day showers and an isolated storm by the later part of the afternoon, early evening, around 3 to 7 o'clock time frame. Then looking into the weekend for Mother's Day weekend, we have that subtropical jet situated across the deep south and the southeast. This will allow real field values to get into the mid 90s for multiple states down to the coastline, including for us here in the Magnolia State. So while Jackson not necessarily expected to hit 90, a couple of places west of I-55 could hit 90 degrees and the rest of us will feel like the 90s. And you're already ready for that cool down. It's coming. Give it until middle part of next week. It looks like temperatures will trend about 5 degrees cooler to the point where we could see wake up temperatures in the low 80s for Wednesday into the rest of next week. So your 7-day forecast stays warm, stays a little bit more summer like. Rain and storm chances dwindle into the weekend. I still think Saturday and Sunday will have the chance for an isolated shower or thunderstorm late in the afternoon, and those rain chances continue into next week. But notice the temperatures, they start to go down a little bit by Wednesday.